Mr. Chairman, thank you for this opportunity for us to come together virtually. There is so much to process. I think we are all still in the state of shock. The Capitol, not only under attack last week, but as you and others have pointed out, there continues to be an effort to undermine our democracy, and there is a continued attack on the Capitol. I find it unsettling that virtually every conversation I have now, whether it's on the phone or in meetings like this, the first question that people ask are you okay and are you safe? I mean, isn't it astonishing that we would have to ask members of Congress whether they feel safe and whether they're safe in simply carrying out their constitutional responsibilities? And we've all been in briefings around security issues, and I obviously am not going to reveal anything that relates to confidential information, but the fact that we continue to have to be briefed on the security leading up to and beyond Inauguration Day is startling. It is shocking. And there is much for all of us to process. I keep thinking to myself that we all need to ask the questions, when does service to Donald Trump end and service to our country and our democracy begin? Because I think we're at that inflection point. I think we were at it months ago. But to every single American, they need to ask themselves that question. It should be an easy one to answer, it seems to me. I am frustrated, I will admit, by the continued conversation, the articulation that this election is not legitimate or was stolen. I think my dear friend Jamie Raskin, I always speak after him. I find myself crossing out a lot of my notes because he articulates so much better than I would many of the same points. And it is so frustrating when there are lawsuits. I served in a state legislature for nearly three decades. And we often state legislatures delegate responsibilities to boards of elections and to secretaries of state, things that are part of the statutes that we pass at the state level. And then to make certain that those statutes are carried out appropriately, we turn to the courts to make judgments on whether the laws have been violated. There is clear, compelling evidence that this election was legitimate, was fair, and record numbers of voters throughout America participated. I find it odd to suggest that somehow the election would not be appropriate because the sitting president got more votes than any person in history, other than Joe Biden, who was elected president with a plurality of over 6 million American votes. And leadership matters. The fact that there are so many Americans now questioning the legitimacy of the election has nothing to do with their insights on the election. It has everything to do with people who continue to undermine it in the national media, on social media, repeatedly, over and over and over again. It is foundational to this democracy. I've been involved in a lot of elections in my life, as a candidate and as many of you, like many of you, as a person helping other candidates. On a personal level, I've won a lot more elections than I've lost, and I'm grateful and I'm blessed that that's the case. But I've been involved with a lot of campaigns on the losing end. And what I've always said to my friends, and I was the party chairman back home for a number of years, when the people speak, we are done. The campaign is over. If we don't believe in that, if we don't come together around that single fundamental issue, we have nothing. There is no democracy. There is no republic. There is no America. It relies on our ability to accept election. The election was not stolen. Those five words need to be said over and over and over again. Less important that it be said by Democrats, more important that it be said by Republicans. This election was not stolen. America will bend, but it will not break, and our democracy will not be undermined.